In this video, I'm going to show you an absolutely awesome exercise to work out your lats, biceps, and core without a pull-up bar. Now, you've heard me say many times before that there's no substitute for pull-ups when it comes to lat development, and that's true. However, there is a substitute for a pull-up bar. It's this SRX suspension trainer that only costs $5 and fits in a little package, much easier to take traveling than a doorway mount pull-up bar. Try fitting one of those in your suitcase. In a minute, I'll show you how to set this up, but first let me illustrate the exercise. You don't need to use straps, I like to. We're gonna hang and put our feet out and pull up and down. That's the basic exercise. Let's talk a bit about form here. First, your thumbs point toward your face, your elbows point forward. So this is what it looks like. Not out like this. That's a different exercise that we're gonna cover next week. Thumbs pointing at you like this. Now, I hate to sound like a broken record, but you know what I'm gonna say next. Pack your shoulders. Please pack your shoulders. What does that mean? You know, shoulders are down and back like this. They're not forward like this. They're not up near your ears, down and back. The whole exercise, keep them like that. And as far as your legs, keep them out horizontal as long as you can, but you know, don't sacrifice the lats. If you can't hold your legs out anymore, you can keep them bent like that or drop them down, but just hold them out horizontal as long as you can. So let me put this all together. Thumbs facing me, elbows forward, shoulders down and back, legs out horizontal, and pull, keeping the shoulders down and back. So let me show you the biggest mistake people make. It's in thinking that more range of motion is better. So what they do is, when they go down like this. Notice where my shoulders are? They're crushing my ears. Instead of keeping the shoulders down and back like that. Really, keep your shoulders down and back. You're proud of those pecs. Stick them out there. Thrust your chest out. And to do that, you have to pack your shoulders. So this is what it looks like. Not like this. Alles klar? Now let's talk a minute about how to set this up. The easiest way to do it is if you have a balcony above you or a stairway, and then you just clip it on a big beam above you. Best is if it's about 10 feet high or a little higher. If it's lower than 8 feet, your knees end up banging the ground when you're doing the exercise. Let me show you what you do if you don't have a balcony or a stairway to tie to. You can use a tree limb that's roughly horizontal or a beam. It's actually not that tough to do. All you need is a big sturdy piece of rope. Now, for God's sake, make sure it's strong enough to hold your weight. What we're gonna do, I have a beam above me about 12 feet up here. A shoe makes a great object to toss the rope up with. So just make a loop and put your shoe through it. Don't, as tempting as it is, do not use a kettlebell for this, okay? That's a little too Laurel and Hardy. So just get a little rope here so it'll feed out freely when we throw it. And we toss it up and over the beam. There we go. And the weight of the shoe should theoretically pull it down. You may have to. Okay, there we go. Now we take our SRX suspension trainer, clip it on. So now we're gonna hoist the suspension trainer up to the beam and tie it off to something sturdy and heavy. And again, for God's sake, tie it to something sturdy. because if it breaks or comes undone, you're going to come crashing to the ground, and that's not good. So not everyone can do this, but I am going to tie it off to my airplane, which has chocks in the wheels, so it's not going to roll toward me. I'm not going to pull it. So I'm going to go ahead and tie it off. So there you have an awesome lat, bicep, and core exercise that you can do anywhere without a pull-up bar. Later this year, I'm going to show you how to incorporate this exercise into some awesome workout plans. Stay tuned for that. Bis nächste Woche, meine Freunde. Auf Wiedersehen. Now, and we're going to toss the shoe up and over the beam. Okay, it landed right on the beam. Good toss. Try that again. Okay, we wind up the rope and throw it up and over the beam. We wind up the rope and throw it up and over the beam. We wind up the rope, making sure to keep a hold of it and let it unwind as we throw it up. Open. So we wind up the rope so that we can let it feed out slowly. So we wind up the rope so we can let it feed out as we throw it up and over the beam.